smartphones and your tablets, I want to invite you to turn with me to the Gospel according to Matthew. Matthew, the 21st chapter. We're going to read verses 1 through 11. Matthew, the 21st chapter. Verses 1 through 11. And I hear these words. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage,
yes,
at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this: the Lord needs them.
Yeah.
And he will send them immediately. This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet,
yes,
saying, tell the daughter of Zion,
right,
look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey,
yes,
and on a colt, the foal of a donkey. The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them, and they brought the donkey and the colt, and they put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. And a very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees, and they spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of them and that followed him, and they were shouting, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven. And when he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, who is this? Who is this? The crowds were saying, this is the prophet. This is Jesus from Nazareth that is in Galilee. This is the prophet, y'all.
Yes.
Jesus,
yes,
from Nazareth in Galilee. This is the word of God for you, the people of God.
Thanks
be to God. Won't you pray with me? God, we thank you now for bringing us to this sermonic moment in our worship. We pray, oh God, thanking you for all that you've already done.
Yeah.
All that you, oh God, are still yet to do in this worship. We pray, God, that we not leave this place the same people as we were when we arrived. But Lord, how could we? For we are having an encounter with the Holy. And so we shall never be the same again. We pray, God, that you would continue to flood, open up the windows of heaven and flood us with your blessing. We pray, God, now still understanding,
yes,
that lest the preacher comes,
yes,
there can be no preaching,
yes,
in this place.
Yes.
So come on, Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Keep on having thine own way.
Yes.
Speak, Lord, for we, your people, are listening.
Yes.
Speak, Lord, we, your people, are listening. We pray this in all. In the sweet, sweet name of the living God. Lord, we use your sons and your daughters. We say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. So again, our gospel lesson this morning comes from the gospel according to Matthew. Matthew, the 21st chapter, and we have lifted up these first 11 verses. So for those of you who have been with us over the last several weeks, you know that we have been participating in a sermon series that has been about giving up various things. But we have talked about giving up control. We've talked about giving up expectations. Giving up superiority. Last week, we even talked a little bit about giving up comfort and what that means. And today, as we read this text of Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem, popularity. Giving up popularity. There's a 32-year-old man named Jason Brown. Jason Brown was one of the best centers in the NFL. At one point, Jason Brown had a 5-year contract that was worth $37 million with the St. Louis Rams. And yet at some point on Jason's journey, he decided that it was all meaningless.
All right. Yeah.
And so he walked away from professional football. His agent looked at him and his agent said, "You are making the biggest mistake of your life."
Oh.
And Jason looked back and he said, "No, I'm not." You see, it wasn't that he just left football, but it is what Jason left football for.
Mm-hmm.
But Jason decided that he wanted to be a farmer, y'all. Now, I'm gonna be clear this morning. Jason Brown has never farmed a day in his life. He does not come from a family of farmers. He did not study agriculture in high school or college. And yet, when asked why he wanted to be a farmer, the man said, "When I think about a life of greatness, when I think about a life of greatness, I think about a life of service."
Yeah.
And so he decided to go and to buy some land and to plant some sweet potatoes.
Whoa.
Now, while being interviewed, he said that when you see them pop up, when you see them pop up out of the ground, it is the most beautiful thing that you could ever see. And I have never felt more successful in my life. Not by man's standards, but in the eyes of the Holy of Holies. And so his plan for his farm, which he calls the first fruits farm, is to donate the first fruits of every harvest to food pantries all around North Carolina.
Yeah.
Because Jason has decided that I want to feed people.
Yeah.
I want to feed people who are hungry.
Oh.
And then Jason Brown goes on and he says that love, y'all, love is the most wonderful currency that you can give.
No.
My.
There's a parade that is occurring as this man named Jesus.
Yeah.
King Jesus, to be specific.
Yeah.
He is triumphantly entering into the city of Jerusalem. And the crowd, y'all, the crowd is very clear about the Messiah that they are expecting.
Yeah, yeah, my Lord. Yeah.
They are very clear about what it is that he has come to do.
Mm-hmm.
For they have already decided that he will be the one that will overthrow the Roman Empire.
Yeah.
He will be the warrior that will put the Jews back on top.
Yeah.
He will end their oppression. He will do what they have long been expecting and waiting for God to do.
All right.
In fact, I am confident this day.
Yes.
That even his disciples that came in the town with him were thinking, finally, he's about to do something.
Yeah.
Finally, he's about to do what we know that he can do.
Yeah.
And so they are listening, and they are delighted as the crowd is saying, Hosanna!
Yes.
Their shouts. Though he knows that the shouts and the admiration and the applause are for him and the kind of Messiah that the crowd is expecting, the kind of Messiah that they are wanting, he knows very clearly who he is and who his God he is.
Yes.
He knows the kind of Messiah that he will be.
Yes.
And unlike so many who crave the fame, so many who desire the admiration and popularity of the people, so many that dilute themselves, so many who let go of their conviction and their values because they don't coincide with what the people want. He is not deterred by the shouts.
Yeah.
He is not deterred by the accolades.
Yeah.
He is not deterred by the mindset of the crowd.
Right.
You see, Jesus, y'all, Jesus knew that popularity is fleeting. People love you today and they can't stand you. Yeah. talk about you. They will always talk about you, good or bad. That is a given. And that's why I try not to get all caught up. Oh, Tiffany, you a good preacher. Oh, Tiffany, this. You know what? I remember when it wasn't nobody but me and the Holy Ghost.
Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.